regions and religion.
I think, as a matter of fact, Isaac Ruto, with regard to these general elections, he has written his own political obituary. In fact, their own friends in KANU were smarter enough.
The leaders called for peace during the nomination exercise. Elvis Kosgei, KTN News, in Uasin Gishu County.
Well, speaking of the anxiety over the primaries, let's cross over to Bomet County, where Deputy Speaker Joyce Laboso is sitting down with your senior political affairs reporter, Duncan Khaemba. Duncan, if you can hear me, good evening. Can we see Duncan? There we go. Duncan, listen, aspirants from Bomet have been very categorical. They're saying that they've warned the party against carrying out primaries that are marred with irregularities. As a matter of fact, they've said these primaries will make or break Jubilee. What's going on where you are?
Yes, Linda, and that informs why we'll not be having a sit-down with the Deputy Speaker, Dr. Joyce Laboso, for the simple reason that our initially scheduled interview had to be interrupted by some urgent matters because, as you've said, aspirants are not taking any chances. Her being among them, they've been, called to a crisis meeting here at the Twigs Hotel in Bomet, simply because there seem to be some little problem which is now causing fresh anxiety as they now do the countdown to tomorrow's Super Friday. Daktari, unfortunately, the crisis meeting aspirants are really very, very worried about tomorrow and during a crisis meeting. What exactly is happening?
Yeah, thank you very much. We are in a crisis meeting. We have been called by our county elections board together with our executive of Jubilee Party to look at what will happen tomorrow. From all indications, we have received ballot papers, which, according to the people that are receiving the arrows, the returning officers are only a maximum of 50% of the registered Jubilee party members. Mm-hmm. Now, this is causing a lot of anxiety because they are all saying, especially like for the governor's seat. You know, they are all saying if tomorrow by 9 o'clock, because everybody, this is a county that is Jubilee, and everybody we know is definitely going to turn up for these elections tomorrow. So they are saying if by 9 o'clock tomorrow the 150 or 200 in a polling center with 500 people and they've only got 150 ballot papers, what happens if 2 hours or so later they have they have finished the ballot papers, what happens? So this is and we are even being informed that even some of the ballot papers don't have some of the names of the MCAs that have that had been fully paid members. So we are trying to see what we can come up with. Yes.
Of course, it's a very delicate and sensitive matter, as you've said, but do you see this as a major crisis because for Jubilee specifically, because they've taken a lot of time to prepare? ODM has been there. You've seen the trouble that they've gone through. And tomorrow is day one for 21 counties. Initially, they were 22 for 21. If that is the case, then what will happen? And it is being said that tomorrow is very critical because the exercise is being done in what are being termed or perceived strongholds for Jubilee.
This is true, and that is why you are seeing the level of anxiety of all the aspirants, because they are saying if we don't get it right, tomorrow, then when will we ever be able to get it right? Because as you have said, a lot of preparations has gone into this exercise. So quite clearly, at some points there was talk of some ballot, a whole ward not having its ballot paper. papers, but that was sorted out because it was discovered they had not removed it from the lorry. So let's allow us to complete, this meeting and see, what is going to be the agreement. You know, at least we are happy with our board. They have called us so that we make a collective agreement as to what is the way forward. Because really, if we have ballot papers that, like, for example, the MCAs that are not on the ballot paper, then how do they get elected, and how do they, what then happens? So I think for now, I would like to leave it at that and allow the meeting to go on so that we can then talk about what the final way forward that will come out of the meeting. Then we can now communicate that to you.
Khaemba, can you hear me?
Yes, before I let you go, Linda can hear you. Yes, Linda.
All right, listening into Mheshimiwa and some of the concerns that she has, you have been on the ground in terms of preparations. Mm-hmm. What have you seen from your end? You're a seasoned political reporter. What have you seen?
Well, Linda, as you speak, of course, it's raining. Bomet, it's close to Kisii, and that has been what we've been experiencing the whole day in Kisii. When we've come to Bomet, it's the same thing, but I think I'll toss that over to, again, Mheshimiwa. In terms of preparations, apart from the hitch that now you're experiencing in terms of the few ballot papers that the county will be receiving, the rains are here. In terms of other preparations, has everything been sorted?
Actually, the other things were in place. We were just having these two major issues of transporting the ballot papers from the tallying centres to the polling centres. That then some areas, the ballot boxes, had also not arrived. And of course, this main one now of not enough ballot papers. The assumption that not more than 50% of, can turn up in our view, in most of the aspirants' view, is a completely wrong assumption. Bomet, for example, I'm sure the way people are so charged about these coming nominations, I'm sure we'll have people in the 70 to 80% of the voters may turn up, for these nominations. There's a lot of psych about the Jubilee nominations, and I'm sure you know now that everybody knows that it is almost like a do-or-die, affair. This is almost like the main elections, in the strongholds of Jubilee, particularly Bomet County. So,
but unfortunately, tomorrow, in as much as it's a do-or-die in the strongholds, the sitting governor has officially been received in NASA's principal number 5, which means now the fight goes down to the wire come August. Should you carry the day tomorrow, and I say should you, do you think it is a done and dusted deal, or it means now the real battle awaits you facing the governor?
Well, the governor, we will face the governor, whether it is a do or die in the elections tomorrow. And as you have said, we wait first of all for the outcome tomorrow. But if it happens to be me that carries the day, definitely we will meet with the governor. And I know, as I've told you, the reason why this Jubilee elections are a do or die, find out how the machinery elections were, how many people participated, how many went to participate. This is a Jubilee zone. And so when NASA comes on board, we will just deal with them as Jubilee. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes. When NASA comes on board, we'll deal with them as Jubilee. That is Joyce Laboso. Remember that for her. It is very critical in this part of the country. They are trailblazers. She's with the late sister and herself, the first elected woman member of parliament in Kipsigis land. So tomorrow, should gods go her way, then she gets that ticket, and perhaps the same happens on 8th August. It will be another moment of history in the making. Yes, Linda.
I was sort of hoping you could ask her about the president's presser this afternoon, sort of reading the riots act. Is she anywhere near you? Can you see her anywhere behind you?
Unfortunately, she is already dashed in because it's a heated crisis meeting in there. Of course, time is running out. They need to go prepare for tomorrow. It will be a long day. So she actually just rushed away because she had to rush inside there to take care of more pressing matters. As I said, this is a crisis meeting.